Hey, jet people. Welcome to Jet City Turbines on the weekend. Now, I know that we ran this thing, this beautiful engine, the next day after I posted that video. And I know that in my video, I yakked a lot and we showed the setup, we showed starting, we showed shutdown. I think we showed shutdown, but basically idling, nothing too fantastic. It was a great test. And then the next day we had to check on the emergency fuel control switch. When you go from main to emergency, you're supposed to have a drop of no more than 300 RPM. And on the day I took that video, the video you just watched, I think, the previous video, we were getting a 1500 RPM drop. So we fixed that, we adjusted it. Electron bill worked as magic. And then we took it, because the customer couldn't visit to witness the test, and our test cell's very busy schedule, we had to get it out of there. So we took this engine right to max takeoff power and showed it on the screen. And then we shut it down and everything was good. And we also timed the rundown from shut off of fuel till stopping turning of the rotor. Anyway, I thought you might want to see that. So that footage is here. Also, we have this sent to us from Ryan in Estonia. One of those cool countries I know nothing about. I'm pretty sure it's a flag. And I don't know what it's supposed to look like, so we're gonna find out. It was sent to Jet City, and the local post office now knows that Jet City is me. Good thing. Here we go. Oh, this is cool. Okay, this must be the small flag of Estonia. Is it this way? Is it that way? The way this sewing is, it could be that way. It's probably not this way. I think this is upside down. Please forgive me. I do not know what it looks like, but this is kind of cool. I think I'm going to put this between the Netherlands and France. Looks like it'll fit. A couple will fit. Although I could put it above Poland. Poland, Australia, and Estonia. Anyway, thank you, Ryan. That's very cool. It's gonna go on the wall of friendship, and I'm glad that everybody in Estonia likes jets as much as everybody else does. Yes.
That was good. I like it.
November 15th?
Yeah. 14th. Okay. November
14th, 2018. Very good. Also, when we shut down, you may have noticed that through this thing right there, that's called the waste oil out, or the waste air outlet, that once we shut down, there was a big puff of mist, looked like smoke, but it wasn't, and some dribbles. That was fuel, because in this guy, in this girl, in this machine, there's a pressurization and dump valve. And what that means is once fuel flow is shut off and things start to wind down, the fuel pressure gets to a point where the valve that normally goes to the fuel nozzles from the fuel system, it shuts off the fuel system and it opens a valve to the waste air outlet. And so the residual air pressure in the engine, which might be 10 or 15 PSI, it's in the combustors from the compressor as it's winding down. That residual pressure is used to make fuel flow backwards out of the fuel nozzles and into the drain. And what that does is it purges the fuel system, so there's no fuel sitting in the fuel nozzles, cooking away with the heat and coking up the nozzles and partially plugging them. It's actually a pretty good idea. So anyway, all that stuff gets blasted out the waste air outlet, which is connected in the plane by a hose to a vent. Let's see, it's a streamlined hole in the aircraft on the lower right from the pilot's point of view. And it pukes out all over the ground. You gotta remember, these planes, these engines were designed in the 1940s, and the environment was a subject that most people would say, what? What was that? The what? The whatment? What are you talking about? We just throw it on the ground. We don't need that fuel anymore. Yeah, so there's no catch can. It just gets sprayed all over the ground. That's what's happening when I say, hey, it's supposed to do that. Yeah, cool. From the shop in front of an Orenda 14 that just passed its test, is ready to go back in a fighter plane. Thanks for watching.